Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the great state of South Carolina. Hallelujah, I was about to give up on the home state of North Carolina, never to go back there again, but it seems as if the baby killers have been turned back. You know, it's so amazing. They said that about 15%, I think it's 15% more of women vote Democrat than they do Republican. And they seem to champion that. They call it, you know, the devil is good at playing on words, like in Big Brother in 1984. They call it pro-choice. And there's lots of women who revel in their right to pro-choice. But in reality, what they're reveling is their right to kill their own flesh and blood. No wonder the Apostle Paul said that in the last days, there would be, you know, what they call an unnatural. Women would have an unnatural affection. That's one of the signs of the end times. Our brothers and sisters, there is nothing more unnatural than wanting to kill the own flesh and blood that's growing in your womb. Brothers and sisters, I can't think of anything worse than that. As the Bible says, you know, wicked people call evil good and good evil. And anyone that would think it's a good idea and a good thing that a woman would kill her own fetus. I mean, you know, I should make a video for the world to see and say, you know, what? How foolish are you? What a fool you are to have drinking the Kool-Aid. You talk about being deceived and being blinded and being tricked. How much more deceived and blinded could you be to think it was a good thing to be able to kill your own flesh and blood, especially women? You know, women traditionally are anti-violence, anti-war, all this, you know, more pro-family, pro, domestic issues. But yet women have bought one of the greatest lies Satan ever came up with, that you ought to have the right to kill your own unborn baby. What blindness, what foolish people, what a foolish, wicked people has become of the United States and the European countries that would kill their own unborn child, flesh and blood, in their womb. I can't think of hardly a greater lie that the devil could come up with. And people talk about Hitler for wanting to kill Jews and gypsies and people like that, you know, the undesirables in the Aryan race. I mean, at least they weren't his relatives, his own flesh and blood, like a woman, you know, having the live baby that had, you know, her own flesh and blood having it, you know, sucked out of her uterus and killed. And sometimes the babies are even born still alive, and then the doctor would pierce the back of their head with a C-clamp, or they call it, you know, and destroy the brain of the prematurely aborted baby. How horrible and how wicked, you know. And that's why I say, whenever I hear a liberal, a pro-abortion, a pro-baby killer talking about Hitler, I tell him, hey, you need to just shut that up right now, because Hitler ain't got nothing. Doesn't have anything on American abortionist doctors who've killed over 50 million innocent unborn children. Hitler didn't kill, you didn't even dream of doing that. And Joseph Stalin and Mao Zedong, none of those guys ever did that. Had the audacity and the ambition to get their own people to kill their own babies while they're still in the womb. How sick is that? Brothers and sisters, thank God we had some, there are Christian women mainly who are in the conservative side, the Republican side. Not all Republicans are Christians for sure. But thank God that the Republicans do have that platform to be, you know, to stop abortion, even though they haven't done it and haven't really done anything about it. But by the grace of God, brothers and sisters, that we would have a chance to have Supreme Court justices if we get a Republican president next time. Can turn this tide of wicked evil back, brothers and sisters. So it's a blessing that maybe, you know, we'll have a window of opportunity here for the United States to be saved, brothers and sisters. Even though we're in the bottom of the ninth, and you know, we got two outs and two strikes against the home team here. If the Lord doesn't come to take his church, brothers and sisters, I pray that if we're still here on earth long enough, that we, you know, that we would see a turnaround in American politics back to, as the word says, righteousness exalts a nation. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I'm just going to put this quick video out. Then I'm going to make a video praying with the anointing oil.